Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Friends, welcome back to my channel. I received this comment from one of my viewers. He asked me, Sir, I am using SMPS TNY266PN IC and I have 300 volt DC but no voltage in the output. What are the problem in it? Go to google.com and search TNY266PN datasheet. Download any PDF datasheet for that IC. We no need to find the schematic diagram for any SMPS. If you want to understand the function of circuit, just only go to the IC which is being used in the circuit and download its sample circuit. It is here, TNY266PN datasheet. Click on this datasheet. alldatasheet.com website is temporarily unavailable. Check that later. No problem, we will see some other. We can download any PDF. So it is here, the datasheet is here, we can download from here. TNY, yes, it is here. Show all, show in folder. Our required file is here. It is TNY 263 to 268, 268. It is a complete family, 263, 64, 65. 67, 68. It is available in different wattage, watt ratings, from 5 watt to 16 watt. It is working at 132 kilohertz. Block diagram of this IC. Drain pin, that is pin number 4, it is connected to the transformer primary winding. And it receives voltage from this pin. Initially when this IC is off, it will apply voltage to this 5.8 volt regulator. So this regulator will provide a charging current, charging voltage to external capacitor, that is VCC capacitor, that is most of the time connected to bandpass, connected to bypass pin, that is pin number 1. When that capacitor will reach at approximately 5.8 volt and maximum 6.3 volt, at that time auto restart counter circuit and line under voltage, this comparator will compare the voltage and it will stop or it will cut the regulator. When it will cut the regulator, the capacitor is charged now. At that time, this auto restart counter will start and the IC will start switching. It will start oscillation. When it will start oscillation, it will drive the internal power MOSFET. It will drive the transformer. At that time it will receive the biasing voltage from bias winding, VCC winding. Here is its pin out. These two are low power ground source pins. And then here is feedback pin, enable pin. Then we have drain pin, that is drive pin to the transformer. And this is power ground for the power MOSFET. It is here. So we can say pin number 2, 3, 7, 8. These four pins are connected to ground. Pin 1, that is VCC. When it will receive voltage, it must start to switch. Let's see its sample circuit. It is 264. It is TNY266P. When this IC will receive voltage here, at that time, it will apply voltage to drain pin and it will start to charge this capacitor. It is 0.1 microfarad, 50 volts. When it will reach at specific voltage level, at that time it will start switching. When it will start switching, it will generate magnetic field in the bias winding and we will receive the voltage at this pin, at this capacitor, that is for smooth running, that are the VCC voltage. In some designs it is taking some voltage from the DC line, that is DC rail high voltage line, It is 1 mega ohm resistor, and it is applying through the optocoupler. When this IC will provide voltage in the output side, at that time this circuit, this optocoupler will enable, and it will provide enable voltage that the output is appeared in the output side. At that time this IC will start smooth running. Now condition, if we have voltage at DC rail, that is here, what are the reasons that this IC is not switching? The first condition, we must receive voltage, positive voltage at drain pin. To test this IC, we need to check voltage, DC voltage, drain to source. If we have voltage around 5 volt, 10 volt, 15 volt, that will indicate that this IC is switching, because we have snubber circuit here. If these voltage are exactly the same voltage which are at the DC rail, that will indicate that this IC is not switching at all. If the MOSFET is turned off and if IC is not getting start, that means we have something wrong in the circuit. So that time the power MOSFET will remain open, and all the voltage, because positive voltage are reaching from this winding to the drain, and source is connected to the ground, so it will indicate that this IC is not starting due to any reason. If we have positive voltage here, exactly same voltage, 300 volts, and we are not getting voltage at this capacitor, that is bypass pin, pin number 1, that capacitor, it must have 5 volts or must have some fluctuating voltage. If we cannot find voltage here, at that time what we want to test, we will test this capacitor. If this capacitor is internally short circuit, it will not allow to build the voltage. It will cause to discharge, because this charging current is very low. It gives soft start to the circuit. But if it is internally short circuit, or it is open, if it is open, it will start immediately, but it will start in fluctuation. If this capacitor is short circuit internally, at that time this pin will not take voltage, this IC will not start. Same time, if this diode is burnout, at that time we have this return path here. All the charging current, charging voltage, will discharge through this diode if this diode is short circuit, that is in VCC winding, VCC path. So at that time we have this path. So we have to test these two components. These are the most critical components in this circuit. If this optocoupler is bad, it will also not allow to make enable signal, sometimes keep this IC in disable mode. If this capacitor is good, this diode is good, if IC is not taking a good start, that means we have wrong in this IC. Its charging circuit is not charging this capacitor. When this capacitor initially, it will not reach at the 5 volt to 6 volt, this IC will never start. In that case we will replace this IC. Then we want to verify this snubber circuit. If this snubber circuit is bad, most of the time this IC will drive in overcurrent mode, or most of the time this IC internal MOSFET will short circuit and it will damage. So pin number 1 is the most critical pin for this IC at initial startup. When this IC will start switching, at that time if we have fluctuation, might be something wrong in the output side, and this IC will go in reboot mode. If it is not turning on at all, that time we have to monitor pin number 1 and its related components. I hope so this video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, any suggestion, let me know in the comment box. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.